Giving a shape to data is a very great way to tell stories and to allow the exploration of topics and information. In this video, I'm going to share with you the tools that I use and also the tips that I use to design data visualizations, starting from a table. Let's start with a practical example. You see that this article talks about the top best-selling books, and this is what we are interested in, this table showing the top 100 best-selling books of all time in the UK. So what I'm going to do is to use just a part of this table and to visualize it. I want to select the top 20 books. I have already copied and pasted all the books on Google Spreadsheet. The first advice is to always have a very clear title for each one of your columns. You see here in the first column we have the rank of the books, then we have the title of the book, the author, the year of publication, the volume sales, and the genre. I'm going to press Command A to select the table, and then Command C to copy it. And then this is the tool that we are going to use. It's called RawGraphs, and it's an excellent free online tool. And it's a great way to do that tricky shift between a table to a visual model, a visual representation. I click on Use it now, and you see we have this blank space, and here we can simply paste our data. You see that they are already perfectly organized. Then, what is great about RawGraphs is that you can select the visual representation, and there are many great options. So, at first I want to select this chart, the bubble chart. The bubble chart is based on a scatter plot. That means that we have an horizontal axis, a vertical axis, and we can arrange our elements according to these two axes. Here in this section we have all the titles of our columns. I want the year of publication to be my horizontal axis and the volume sales to be my vertical axis. And you see what is great is that you can see in real time your visualization taking shape. Then, of course, I want to see what is the title of the books here on the label variable. And you see that I am immediately reading the titles. Then there is another variable that I am interested in showing, and this is the genre, and I want to be the color. Then we can edit the size of our artboard to avoid overlappings. The colors, we can already edit directly from here, and the labels. This is already a way to visualize this data. But as I was mentioning, we can visualize the same dataset using different possible options. So I want to come back here, and this time I want to use this graphic, linear dendrogram. You see, it works as it worked before. In this case, I want the author to be my first step, the title to be the second one. You see that we have already grouped the titles in the different authors. And then I want the genre to be the color again. I want the rank and the title to be my label. And then I also want to add the volume sales data. And here we have our visualization. So what I love about this tool is that you can then export the graphic that you've realized both as an image, but as an SVG file. So I'm going to download it. And you see, it's great because it's a vectorial file, so you can edit in Illustrator as you want. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please remember to follow Domestika on social media. And if you're interested in exploring the data visualization topic, check out my online course at Domestika.